telling us that God is still in control. So we begin to thank the Lord, amen, for our brother, amen, Rashawn. Amen. I see him. I don't see him now, but maybe he left out for whatever reason. But I thank and praise God, amen. He was here just to hear the word of God just on this morning. Remember Sister Carlton, amen, Sister Graham, Sister Annette. Also remember, my God, Sister Raven. I got a chance to see her last week. She told me she wasn't going to be here. They got her working and stuff. So just keep her in your prayer. Sister Christelle, amen, keep her in prayer as well. Amen. On the high seas, amen, defending the country in the Navy. But I thank and praise God for both of them because of what they have meant to the body of Christ. Truly young women, amen, the enemy wants to deal with them, amen, but the adversary of our very soul, but the God of our salvation says not so. So I thank and praise God for both of them, amen. I've been there before. Amen. So God, he is truly a good God. We begin to look at this passage of scriptural saints of God. There's something, amen, that's very important that we begin to realize, amen, that we look at this, amen, the building of this temple. God had put two people really in charge of this thing. It was Zerubbabel, amen, the governor, and it was Joshua, amen, the high priest. But the thing about it, man, that God has never left himself without a witness, amen. Somebody that can, amen, can take note, a ready scribe, amen. And that was Ezra, amen, taking notes, amen, writing down the things that was going on for the history, amen, of Israel. So the building, amen, of this temple, amen, in Jerusalem, it was a big deal, amen, for the all people right. of God. The temple saints of God, it represent, amen, their relationship with God. And so as people of God, amen, the Bible said our body is a temple of the Holy Ghost, amen. And he said if you destroy this temple, my God, he will destroy you. So there was something very important for them, amen. And we begin to realize that the temple represents the very presence of God. So look at verse number 7. He says, who art thou, O great mountain? He said, before Zerubbabel thou shalt be made or become plain, and he shall bring forth the headstone that was shouting and crying, grace, grace to it. As so we begin to look at these scriptural saints of God, there's a lot of things, amen, that's really going on in here, amen, that we don't really have time, amen, to go into great detail. But there's, amen, a prophetic word, amen, that talks about this headstone. It talks about, amen, this mountain, but it's not really that mountain, amen, per se, but a mountain, amen, that's something, amen, that stops the move of God. It's something, amen, that stops the progress of God. He called it, amen, a great mountain. And so in this passage of scripture, amen, it talks about the enemies, amen, that surround us around Jerusalem, amen, that surround, amen, the people of God. So we got to realize something here. So when God say, amen, this great mountain, and sometimes saints of God, there are things that are in our eyes, amen, that look small, glory be to God. Sometimes most of us are heard and saying, you're making, amen, a molehill out of a mountain, glory be to God. But when you're in the flesh, amen, that molehill can become a mountain. But as saints of God, our mountain, my God, can become a molehill because we know, my God, in Christ, my God, we live and move and we have our very being. And so he began to speak this word to Zerubbabel. Amen. Thank God for the prophet. Thank God, amen, for the man of God that could come and speak a word into the life, amen, because no doubt he began to rebuild this, amen, this temple here. It had been ruins, amen. And so Zerubbabel had been given the charge to go and rebuild this thing again. But saints of God, there's always something. There's always opposition that come up against us. The Bible said the adversary, the devil, goes about as a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. And so that's why I begin to read that scripture in Ezra, amen, that they heard him and they're going to rebuild this temple, but they wanted to come and help them. As saints of God, beware of people who want to help you do good. Beware of people who want to help you in your situation, because sometimes there's a price to pay. And glory be to God, if it's not of God, don't be easily deceived, because some people, amen, that have been wrong friends, there's something attached to it. And so they say, you, my God, has nothing to do with this. And so saints of God, some of us have got to speak to that mountain, amen, and that situation, say, you got nothing to do with my salvation, amen. You had nothing to do with that when God brought me out of darkness into his marvelous light. You had nothing, my God, to do with it. And so that's why I was saying you have to speak to this mouth and cry unto God and say, God, your grace and your mercy is what brought me through. It's not the adversary that's pushing you, but it's the God, my God, was like. This is the story, my God. It tells something to us. He said, grace. He said, cry grace. Grace to it. What is grace, my God? Grace is the unmerited favor of God. Grace, amen. It means that we didn't get what we deserve. It means, my God, we deserve to die. But God's grace and his mercy. As a matter of fact, John 3:16 says, that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes him shall have eternal life, my God. That's what grace is. I deserve to die, my God. But God loves us not so. He looked down through the end of time and saw us, my God. And he made, my God, himself of no reputation. And he hung on a cross, my God. It's already been paid. But when we think about the goodness of Jesus, it's God's grace and his mercy. Speak to your mountain on this morning. Whatever it is that you got going on in your life, my God, depression, my God, speak to it and say, God, your grace and mercy ain't got nothing to do with your salvation. Depression is of the adversary, yes it is. Anxiety is of the adversary. Defeat is of the adversary. Speak to your mountain, saints of God, on this morning. We begin to think about, amen, what grace really is. He said, listen, the grace of God. Thank you, Jesus. In Ephesians, my God, the second chapter, verse number 8 says, by grace are you saved through faith. He said, not of yourselves, but it's a gift of God. It's a gift of God that God saved me out of my sins. But when I come to the knowledge of the truth, I begin to realize, my God, this is amazing grace that saved a wreck like me. Glory be to God. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, my God, but now I see. I believe God. And so therefore it's nothing, no goodness of our own. But we hear the word of God and say, somebody pray for me. Somebody had me on their mind. Thank God for the people of God that are praying for that sinner man, that sinner girl, that person out there on the street. I thank and praise God for those, my God, that said, Lord, save that sinner man. Who, my God, was one of those sinner men, that sinner young man, my God. But I thank God that he had enough, my God, to call me out of that thing and to put me in his kingdom in the name of Jesus. I thank you on this morning. He talks about this thing again in Titus, my God, the second chapter, verse number 11. He said, for the grace of God that bringeth salvation have appeared unto all men, teaching us, my God, he said, teaching us. He told him, go forth and teach, my God. He said, deny ungodliness and worldly lusts, that we should live soberly in righteousness and godliness in this present world. Yeah. Saints of God, I'm talking about when we begin to realize what the world is trying to do to us today. He said, you got to teach them, my God. You got to deny unworldliness. You got to deny ungodliness. You got to live, my God, holy and righteous in this life. And so therefore, when these people begin to come to Zerubbabel and say, listen, let us help you with this thing. Somebody got to have enough Holy Ghost to stand up and say, hey, you got nothing to do with rebuilding of this temple. Speak to your mountain on this morning. You got nothing to do with my situation. I'm trying to get to a place in God, and you are nothing but a hindrance. You, my God, as a matter of fact, you got to speak to it and say, get thee behind me, Satan. Because he is a buffoon of the brothers. He is, amen, the one that calls us, amen, to doubt God at times. But I'm telling you, saints of God, just like the song says, his grace and his mercy, it brought me through. You got to realize that in this moment that you're living, it's for Christ. You got to live, amen, a life, my God, that's above sin and reproach. You got to live a life, my God. Sometimes it seems that when the world is so upside down, that it's easy, my God, to shine in a dark place. But what the enemy wants you to do, he wants you to become frustrated so you can't live, my God, according to the will of God. But I'm here to tell you, to put him on notice. The devil, my God, he is a liar. Because, my God, we live under grace. We live under God's grace and mercy. People begin to think that's a license to sin. People begin to think that's a license, my God, to live any kind of way. People think, my God, because we're under grace, I can go out and sin with the very intent that I can go to God and say, forgive me. The devil is a liar. Because, my God, Romans the 6th chapter, now verse number 1 and number 2, it said, my God, how can we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? He And so the people begin to think, in order to get more grace, my God, they can sin more. Glory be to God. That's just like a child when he wants more attention. He begins to act up. Yes, he does. And so that's what some of the saints, they begin to want some attention, and they begin to act unseemly. But God, my God, he said, once the Holy Ghost comes, you're going to have power to live above sin and reproach. Once the Holy Ghost comes, you got power to resist the devil. But you got to draw nigh to God first. Draw nigh to God. Resist the devil. Then he will flee from you. But you find here, my God, in Ezra, my God, the fourth chapter, listen what happened. You see, we read it here. He said they began to hire counselors to weaken the hands of the men and the people of God, to cause frustrations, my God, to cause them, amen, not to finish the task that was before them. Saints of God, there's some things, amen, that God has spoken in your life, and for whatever reason, the enemy has came in to try to frustrate you until you can't get to your design purpose in God. Some of us, God has spoke to a long time ago and said, you're going to be here and doing this, that, and the other. But somewhere along the way, the mountain became, my God, that molehill of doubt and fear. I'm nervous. Now that molehill become, my God, a mountain of I'm afraid to step out. You got to speak to it and say, you have no part in my life. You got no part in my children's life. You got no part in my marriage. You will have no part, my God, in everything in my finances. You got no part in it. It's a mountain, saints of God, that you're going to have to learn to speak to. And that's what I like about the word of God, because it came to Zerubbabel. It said, this is the word of God. Oh, great mountain. He said, this thing is going to remain plain. But what you got to realize, saints of God, my God, my God, the kingdom of God, listen, it'll stand forever. But somebody that's in the earth now has got to stand for God. Somebody in the earth right now has got to put up, my God, to put on the clothes of righteousness. Somebody got to be holy in an unholy world. Somebody gotta have some common sense in a word that seems like it lost all of its senses. Somebody gotta stand for the true and living God. We gotta stand. He said, having to done all to stand. When we stand, my God, opposition is gonna come. It's gonna come from all sides. And if you're not careful, it'll come from your own household. But you gotta stand for the true and living God. And therefore, saints of God, Hebrews the fourth chapter, verse number 16. Listen what it happened here. He said, let us therefore come boldly, my God, unto the throne of grace, that we might obtain mercy. Listen what it says. Some people think that this means that I can come to God in an old kind of way. But he's talking to people that are saved. He said, listen, when you come boldly, my God, to the throne of grace, that you might have mercy. And so, saints of God, yeah, we're going to fall. Yeah, my God, we're going to get tripped up along the way. But we come boldly to the throne of grace, asking God for some mercy. I preached a message not too long ago. As a matter of fact, it wasn't long ago. It was up, my God, at Bishop Green. It said, grace, grace, grace. Just a little more grace. And saints of God, how many need just a little more grace on this morning? Because, yeah, we fall short sometimes. Yeah, my God, we fail God in praying and fasting. Yeah, we fail God in reading the word of God. But somebody got to speak up in the household against the adversary. I remember Pastor Baker said, if wife and mother don't go, somebody got to go in your household. You got to be able to speak up, my God, and say, listen, enemy, you have no part in this. He said, how, my God? He said, grace for grace. You're going to find, my God, help in the time of need. This grace that I'm talking about, it calls us to overcome. It calls us to stand against the wiles of the devil. This grace that I'm talking about, it enables us, oh my God, to stand against that evil day. It's enabled us, my God, to have a peace of mind late in the midnight hour when the finances might not look too good. But in the morning, my God, weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. I'm here to tell you, your morning will have to be 6 hours later. But when you come to the realization that for God I live, and for God I die, if I speak to this
mountain right now and say, be thou removed. My morning has just showed up. Even though it's black as my God on the outside, the sun has not risen yet, but it has risen in my heart. Glory be to God. I'm talking about the S-O-N and not the S-U-N, because we are spiritual creatures. Yes, we are. We've been born again, my God. We've been born of the blood. We've been born, we've been washed in the blood and born of his spirit. I'm talking about this man called Jesus. I'm so excited about the word of God. I'm talking about grace, saints of God, that will put us in a situation. As a matter of fact, when Paul was dealing with this sin of, my God, of sin that began to come and to buffet him about, he said, I sought the Lord three times for this thing. And he said, listen, and God came back with a response. Yes, it is. And so, saints of God, when you begin to seek God, prepare yourself for a response. Yes, it is. Sometimes the response might not be what you think it's going to be. Glory be to God. I'm a man of God. But look at what the response is. Lord, I suffer many things for your name. But look at what the response is. He said, Paul, my grace is sufficient for you. In other words, what I brought to you is my grace is sufficient. And I help you in the time of need. And so, saints of God, even though the report might not be what you think it is, but it's God's grace and mercy. Something that we go through in life that calls us to keep on our knees, because soon we get healed, we begin to run out of the church of God, fail to give God the praise and the glory. Say, Lord, my God, I just want to thank you. We run out of the church of God, forget to give God the praise and the honor. We forget what God done for us. We were flat on our backs, couldn't move, didn't know, my God, whether it was Monday or Sunday. But when God raised us up, he said, listen, will you be able to give me the praise, the honor, and the glory? And that's why Paul said, I learned to be content whatever state that I find myself in. And so, saints of God, we got to realize our mountains, we got to speak to them. It's a situation that's going on in our life. In spite of what it is, I begin to realize that God knows what's best for me. And so, therefore, you think a good thing about rebuilding this temple. Why would God put opposition there? So we learn to realize that we got to depend on God. Your enemies might have you surrounded, but you stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Don't get flighty. Don't get fearful. Don't be doubting God. Don't make unholy alliances. Glory be to God. But you hold on to the word of God. He said, hold on to God's unchanging hand. He said, in the fullness, oh my God, have you received grace for grace? I'm talking about the grace of God. I'm talking about the ability that God has given us to walk this life. Things are happening at a rapid pace. And if you find yourself on the wrong side of the fence, so to speak, you want to find out, how can I get back over? He said, hide the word of God in your heart that you might not sin against you. I'm here to tell you on this morning, as things begin to happen at a very rapid pace, watch your conversation. The people that you've been sitting alongside all this time, the enemy is going to get up and going to raise his ugly head. But you have got to maintain all that while you've been saved and sanctified and filled with the Holy Ghost. Can I talk to somebody on this morning? Can I help you, my God, with the things of this world? You have got to realize who you are. The enemy of your soul, he's going to test you. He's going to try you to see who you say you are. You might have been on this job for 19 years. That all they saw was a holiness in you. All they heard when you cried, holy, 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 Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. But now in these last and evil days, the conversation now arise. There's a different man in the White House now. That some things are about to change. But no matter what change around you, the Holy Ghost that's down on the inside, he said, I'll keep you in perfect peace if you keep your mind staying on me. Don't worry about what people say. Look unto the hills from which cometh your help. Your help come from the name of the Lord. Zerubbabel, he had been my God. He got a little frustrated because the people, they begin to do the things what they want to do when they want to do it. Yes, they did. They begin, my God, to rebel. Listen, whenever God gives you an assignment to do, you got to finish it until the end. And that's what God was telling Zerubbabel through the prophet Zechariah. He said, listen, I gave you this thing to do, and at your hands, it's going to be finished. Saints of God, I'm here to tell you on this morning, God has given you an assignment to do. And at your hands, nobody else but yours, opposition will come. But guess what? You are the one that God has ordained to do it. He said, if you live God in this present world, you're going to suffer some afflictions. You're going to be talked about. You're going to be ridiculed. You're going to be called this, that, and the other. But God said, I've called you a child of God. We're heirs and joint heirs with Christ Jesus. We begin to read on, amen, in this book of Ezra. Listen, when they began to lay the foundation, he said those ancient men, those that had been there from the beginning, that had saw the foundation being laid, he said they began to weep. My God. In other words, they were so excited. They weep because they saw that there's something that got started and didn't get finished. But now it is, my God, it be coming up again. As Zerubbabel laying the foundation, the word of God said, those, amen, was weeping with a loud voice. And said, those, my God, that was joyful with a loud voice. He said there was both weeping and joyful silence. That the enemy so far off, they couldn't tell the difference. Glory be to God. What am I trying to say to the saints of God? Even though, my God, they were weeping tears of joy, the enemy could not tell why. And so what am I saying for us on this morning? Yeah, we might have somebody that's going through and they're weeping and they need to say, Lord, how long will you have me in this situation? They're weeping, my God, and saying, Lord, how long? But for those that are praising God for the things that he has done, my God, if a joyful sound that the enemy can't understand, he knows, my God, that he has beat you up all week, but you got to a place that it becomes one sound unto the God. He thinks, my God, that everybody, my God, hit me out. He thinks, my God, that you have came to the house of God. Yeah, you need strength, but you're crying out unto the Lord on this morning. Say, God, I need you now more than ever. And there's somebody saying, Lord, I just want to thank you because I seen another birthday. Well, happy birthday today and tomorrow. If that would get you to talk and set up on God, I'm going to tell you happy birthday today. I'm going to tell you happy birthday tomorrow. I'm going to tell you happy birthday on Wednesday. If that would cause you to get up and give God some praise, happy birthday 24/7. My God, 365. Glory be to God. And so when we come into God's house, he says, I will bless the Lord at all times. And his praises shall continue to be in my mouth, my God. He said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Saints of God, those that are going through, cry out unto God. Those that have testimonies of victory, cry out to God. And so when the enemy on the outside, he can't distinguish between those that are weeping and saying, how long? Between those that are crying, I said, Lord, I just want to thank you. And become one sound to the enemy, he cannot recognize. And so therefore, he begins to understand. He said, they have gotten to the house of God. They'll make a joyful noise. My God, I want to get out of here. I want to begin to flee the scene. Because if I get out, if I stay around just a little while longer, they're going to have some strength, my God, to put me under their feet. Glory be to God. And this is what I'm saying to the saints of God. Zerubbabel, he was a man of God. Yes, he was. But God has given him an enabling word. And saints of God, what did the word say? Hide the word of God in your heart that you might not sin against you. It said desire the word of God more than your necessary food. The word of God is a light unto my path and a lamp unto my feet. The word of God is what's going to keep me in these last and evil days. The only way that I can know God in a better way is through his word. The only way that I can resist the devil is through the word of God. The only way that I can tell my children, you got to live this life if I live before, because my life has now become a living pistol seen in red men. Men, whether be your own household or those on the outside looking in, or those that are on my job, you got to live a life that's set before them, that cannot, my God, be the spirit. What am I trying to say? If you live holy on Sunday, Monday is coming. Can you still live holy then? Tuesday is coming. Can you still live holy then? When they say all manner of things against you, can you still be holy? I'm here to tell you, yes, you can. And so he began to see this thing. Listen, saints of God, they begin to have their own agenda. They begin to put the things before God. My God, their own personal lives before God. And sometimes that's how it is with the people of God. We begin to put other things before God. Greater high hope. I'm here to tell you, our bodies are the temple of the Holy Ghost. Don't lose your desire for God. Don't lose the dedication. Don't lose commitment to the house of God just because it's not your program. Just because you're not leading the service on today, you got to come to the house of God with an expectation. God, I just want to thank you one more day that I came into the house of God, that I gave you all that I have. I'm here to tell you, saints of God, too many of us allow the adversary to get the best of us. But I'm here to tell you, don't let the adversary get the best of you. This is very important. Understand this. Instead of allowing the adversary to get the best of you, you got to give the adversary the best you have. The best that I have is down on the inside of me. It's the Holy Ghost. When he comes in, I give him my best. Hallelujah. If it's a song in my heart, I give him my best. If it's a praise on my lips, I give him the best. If it is, my God, it's a 1-2 punch. What is a 1-2 punch? Prayer and fasting. That's what I got to give the adversary on this morning. He cannot have me. He cannot take my joy. He cannot have my children. Reclaim them in the name of Jesus. And so, saints of God, don't let the enemy come in like a flood. When the flood comes, lift the standard. That standard is Holy Ghost, not by power, not by might, but by my spirit. Peter, he tried to cut the man's ear off. Yes, he did. That was by his own strength. God says, now put the sword away and watch what I do. I'll restore the man's ear. This is the power of God. And saints of God, God will put a situation before your life. You won't get the credit because if you think you're doing it of your own strength, you say, look what I did. But God, he deals in impossible situations. As a matter of fact, he said, what's impossible to man is possible unto God. What did it mean? He said, because I can get the glory out of your impossible situation. I don't know how you got out of that. You tell him to God be the glory of the things that he has done in my life. When I begin to think, he said, Jeremiah 29:11. Listen to what he said. He said, for I know the thoughts that I think towards you. What is God thinking towards you on this morning? Listen to what he said. He said, listen, he said, thoughts of peace and not of evil to give you an expectant in. They say, I'm going to hold out and see what the end going to be. I would know what the end going to be.
Yes.
If I live this life.
Yes. Yes.
If I live this life.
Yes.
Whether I go by the grave or I meet him in the air. Yes. That's what my expected end is.
Yes.
To forever be with the Lord.
Nah.
My God.
My Lord.
The enemy, when he comes, he'll find nothing in me.
Yes.
We got to live this thing.
yeah, frustration gonna come. Don't complain about the bad knee. Cry unto God. I will bless the Lord at all times. Finances, I will bless the Lord at all times. We'll begin to make that situation a mountain. God has given us the authority and the power to speak to the mountain. As Matthew told me, he said, you've got faith the size of a grain of mustard seed. Speak to this mountain, it'll fall into the sea. That's what the power he told the disciples. If you got that kind of faith. Faith, faith, faith. My God. He said, when I come, will I find faith in the earth? Yes, he will. Because we're faithful. We're faithful, my God. Look what God has done. And look at what God has done, it should give us an expectation of what God can do. He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Let's go and finish this thing up. That's the thing here that we got to realize, saints of God. He said, because of their unbelief, they couldn't hear the serpent. But he said, you got to have faith the size of a mustard seed. When you make a joyful noise, broken hearts will become mended. When friends turn against you, you can say, Lord, I just want to thank you for the time that you gave them to me, and we were friends. Love them. He said, with love, you'll heap hot coals on their head. A negative report, you got to cry. To God be the glory. Whether he does it or not, I know God is able. Envy and strife and jealousy make a joyful noise unto the Lord. The enemy don't realize, amen, when you're crying out to God, you're saying you're grounding him out. Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. When you're crying out to God, you're grounding out the negative report. Glory be to God. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Make it unto God. Thank you, Jesus. Your mountain will become plain. Your mountain will become plain. There's a lot, amen, as saints of God that we can go through. I remember this song. I'm not a singer and don't plan to be, they ain't gonna try to be one. I know what God has called me to do, preach the word of God. This song, he says, blessed assurance. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. He said, I got the assurance that Jesus is mine. He said, what a foretaste. Of what? Glory. Of glory divine. My God. Glory divine. God was manifested in the flesh. He was both human and divine. Yes, he was. Yes. A glimpse of him. He's an heir of salvation. That's what we are, saints. We're an heir of salvation. Salvation was to the Jews only. But my God, who's rich in grace and mercy, and say he has appeared to the Gentiles as well. Purchase of who? My God. Purchase of God. On the cross, my salvation has been purchased. I'm so glad that he came and made it that way. Because I can be broke, busted, and disgusted, but salvation, my God, has been already purchased by Jesus. Tell the Lord thank you. Born of his spirit. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost. He said, washed in his blood. The Holy Ghost, my God. Baptism in the name of Jesus Christ. Washed in his blood. Though my sins be as scarlet, they should be made whiter than snow. The Spirit of God, the power of the Holy Ghost. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior every once in a while. When things are going good, he said, all the day long, I'm going to praise. Hallelujah! Can you praise God in the midst of what you're going through? Lift up a praise. When they attack your finances, lift up a praise. He said, this is my story. This is my song. This is my song. This is my song. Perfect submission. Can you submit to God? No matter what you're going through. Can you be humble on your knees and say, I'm going to submit to the will of God. Not my will, but thy will be done. Perfect delight. Delight yourself. Delight thyself. In the Lord. he would do what? Give you the desires of your heart. Delight yourself, saints of God. When you come into the house of God, have an expectancy that when I ask for God, that God will do it because I'm his child. He purchased me with his blood. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. This is a rapture.
Yes.
See, you guys start thinking rapture now. Woo! Think about the goodness of Jesus. No more sickness. No more pains. No more fear. No more heartbrokenness. My God. Hallelujah. No more where my next meal is coming from. My God. When I think about what God can do. He's his angels descending from above. My God. Those seven eyes are the angels of the Lord going to and fro. Paul said, the angels stood by me this night and told me none shall be lost. He said, and I believe God. Do you believe God on this morning for whatever it is that your mountain is? Do you believe God? If you believe God, then speak to your mountain and tell him you got no business. You got nothing to do with what God has done for me. Thank you, Jesus. Tell the enemy, you got nothing to do with this. And when you speak to him, you got to speak with the authority of God. Speak through the power of the Holy Ghost. Zerubbabel, he was discouraged. But the man of God came with the word. Saints of God, what you going to do when the word of God comes? I said, thank you, Jesus, for the word. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. It might not be what I thought it was going to be, but it was just what I needed. We sing the song, he's an old-time God. Yes, he is. He may not come when you want him. Hallelujah. But he's an old-time God. God is an old-time sister Tyler. He sees that I was hurting her. My God. But he's an old-time God. She's still jumping and praising God. Oh, my Lord. I want to step over and say, hey, but who am I? Hey, man, to stop the praises of God, of his people, and God has stopped glory to God. When they're praising God, you can't stop somebody from praising. Say, you can't tell it. Let me tell it what God has done. I remember, my God, I was in the Navy playing basketball. A pastor sitting up on the stage. I did some kind of move, boy. I don't even know what it was. He said, praise the Lord. Listen, your daddy. I said, he's my dad. He's my spiritual father. He said, you did something, boy. He jumped up and said, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And a ball game. He said, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It just comes out of you. I said that to say this. I was at a game yesterday. And old Josh, he hit this boy. Man, boom. I said, I see you, 2-5. He made a run, cut through the line. I said, go, 2-5, go. Lady sitting there in front of me, she said, that must be your youngin'. I said, yes, it is. Say some God. Can we shout, my God, and say, praise the Lord, in the midst of things. He said, well, you must know the Lord. Your mouth, your speech should be trained. My speech be trained because he said, that must be your youngin'. Pastor's speech be trained because he said, praise the Lord. Say some God. Speak to your mountain and say, you got no part with this. Pay my strength in the Lord.
Hallelujah.